I was toting my pack along the dusty Winnemucca road, when along came a semi with a high canvas covered load. If you're going to Winnemucca, Mac, with me you can ride. And so I climbed into the cab and then I settled down inside. He asked me if I'd seen a road with so much dust and sand, and I said, listen, I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert, bare man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla, I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert, bear man. I beat the mountain air, man. Travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Boston, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston, Texas, down to Monterey, Faraday, Santa Fe, Tonopussy, Glen Rock, Black Rock, Little Rock, Oskaloosa, Tennessee, Tennessee, Chicopee, Spirit Lake, Grand Lake, Devil's Lake, Crater Lake, Peach Lake. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert, bear man. I beat the mountain, man.
Hey, patrol members, welcome back. It's a nice, mild Friday evening, and I wasn't planning on making a video today, but the opportunity presented itself, so I'm going to do it. So let's get right to the point. For years, decades, I have listened to old radio shows. And if it's one thing an old radio show tells you that goes together, is a fine pipe or a fine cigar with a glass of port. You have this Croft Reserve Tawny Port. Right there. We knocked the dust off of it. Now, I have absolutely no idea how old this port is. There you go. The tax stamp says 2005. And I have absolutely, mind you, picked this up when I went up to Pismo Beach after my brother-in-law passed away. We went to a liquor store up there and I bought a bottle of Rough Rider whiskey, batch number one, which is going to remain unopened. And I bought this 2005 bottle of port. So let's find out about it. Croft Reserve Tawny Port. Croft, established in 1588. Bottled in Portugal. The distinguished house of Croft was founded over 400 years ago in 1588. A rich heritage of skills and experience in aging and blending the very finest ports. There you go. Your ability to drive a car or operate machinery may be impaired. All right. This is imported from Portugal into New York. There's a serial number on the bottle. Now, so many people are going to go, why didn't you give us a serial number? Okay, it's LK18290. Carefully blended from the finest wood matured ports using skills passed down through generations. And seasoned in oak casks, which gives it its seductive amber color, silky smoothness, and rich, mellow flavors. Whoa. So I paid $30 for this 2 years ago. And I'm just getting around to it. So let's get that open. Now the knife I'm using for things tonight, I bought 2 months ago. It's a very old Camillus Stockman's knife. And you can tell by the way the blade has been honed to this weird shape that somebody used this knife for years and years and years and is still very sharp. The sheep's foot has still got most of its original shape, but the small blade is really worn down. But I'm going to use the sheep's foot. The sheep's foot, that's what this blade is called, to cut the seal here. I should have gone and got a can opener. I'm in terrible shape. Okay, let's get it open. It's a little vinegary smelling. Now port lasts for a long time. And I went so far as to get a port glass. And I'm pouring a small dollop of port. I'm gonna let that breathe for a bit. Got a nice rich color, and we're just going to let that breathe. Now, you might notice in the video, which you're going to see this coming Saturday, and I apologize if for being a long one, you might see that I have a tremor going on here. Some days it's worse than others. I did talk to my doctor about it. He seems to think it's a side effect of my being ill. It was worse, now it's a lot better. But I was a little concerned about it. I discovered if I sit back and relax, just take a breath, it'll go away. So I don't know, is it a case of nerves? I don't know. What do I have to be nervous about? I don't know. I am going to have one of my Nestor Maduros. These are great cigars. I cannot think of a better cigar to go with the port. And of course, the ubiquitous grape Kool-Aid, which goes great with cigars. That has a good draw on it. It might be, I might have nerves. My wife and I have this ongoing legal thing with my brother-in-law's estate. We're not being sued or anything like that. It's just that California moves with the speed of sloth. He makes flash from Zootopia. Well, the state of California makes flash from Zootopia look like the actual DC flash, you know. Anyway, we finally have a court date. It's not as soon as we'd like, but at least we have the date. We're going to appear in person, so after that date, we'll let you know what happens. For those of you who are wondering why I'm eating a match head, because my uncle taught me to do that when I was little. I was about 3 or 4 years old, and I saw my uncle doing that, and I wanted to know why. And I said, I don't know why. Want me to show you how to do it? And I said, yeah. Of course, I'm a little kid. And, once my parents saw that, they never let my uncle watch me again. So later on, when I was a little older, we lit firecrackers together, he and I. But he was a good man, my uncle. I cared about him a lot. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that is a fine cigar. It is better than the Churchill, which was a good cigar. Let's get to this port. Reaches out of frame. Port. Now, you can't see it on camera, but when I hold it up here, in the fading light of the day, it does have a reddish amber hue, almost like some kind of gemstone. It's very nice. And let me take a sip and I'll let you know how it is. Whoa. Patrol members, that is good port. Wow. No weird aftertaste, no bitterness. Smooth, sweet. You can smell and taste the oak. And I'm not being even the slightest bit facetious about that. That is outstanding port. Wow. Yes. Fine cigar and a fine port are really suited to each other. I'm going to cork this up. I don't want any oxidization to go on here. That is really good. That is really good. That is excellent. Now, Croft Reserve Tawny Port. Now this is 2005. I'm going to see if there's any other dates available. Man, that's got a nice warming feeling going down. Now I don't see any place on this bottle that says what the percentage is. That might not be a requirement for ports in other countries. Vinho do Porto. That must be Portuguese. Oh, I'm wrong. This is 40 proof. That's pretty potent. That's pretty potent. Man. I'm gonna put this right there. That really deserves to be seen right there. We gotta have another sip. Oh yes. Oh yes. Hmm. So once again, for the future, I have like 5 whiskeys to review. I've got 2 gins. I have James's gin. So if any of you folks used to watch Top Gear, James May was one of the presenters, and I bought his gin. I bought regular and naval strength. Now, naval strength means that if you pour a pile of black powder into an open pan and you fill the rest of the pan up with gin, so it's halfway up the powder, when you light the black powder at the top, it needs to burn all the way down through the gin. So that's naval strength. It cannot dampen the powder. I have a couple of mix-it-yourself drinks, beverages. One of which I got at Kohl's. Wait a minute. Not Kohl's. It's been over a year since I got it. Steinmart. And then the other I bought at a roadside fruit stand. Now I say roadside fruit stand. It's really big. It's a store. But they sell all kinds of fruits and vegetables and dried fruits and all kinds of great stuff there. But they were selling these quart jars where you pour in your liquor and seal it up. And it's full of all these different dried fruits and spices and sugars and things like that. And you shake it up really well and then you store it in the fridge. And whenever anything inside blends, you drink it. And it, you know. So I have those two to do. I think I'm going to do those closer to the holidays because they seem more like a holiday thing, you know. So what holidays do we have coming up? We have Labor Day, Halloween, Thanksgiving, and Christmas. Man, when you were a kid, didn't it take forever for Christmas to get here? And now it's, at some point in your life, it became New Year's, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, Thanksgiving, Christmas. And now at my age, it's birthday, birthday, birthday. Time just flies. But next year, I'll only be 1/70th as old as I was the previous year. So, when you're 1, you're 1. 2, if you think about it, that's your worst birthday because you double your age in a year. But when you're 3, you're only a third as old. And when you're 4, you're a quarter. And so on down the line. So I'm 1/70th. So that's not too terrible. Right? Hmm. So the Nestor, even though it's a Maduro cigar, a dark cigar, it is mild, draws easy, it's not hot. It has a fine white ash. It's burning evenly. It's not canoeing, it's not acting funny. I'll definitely get these again. I still got like 10 more left. We'll set the port over here because I don't think I'm going to be needing two glasses. That's like damn near two beers right there. I picked up two watches from John, the Seiko dealer. He lives up here in there is a shop up here at the corner of Azusa and Arrow Highway. Right in that little shopping center just to the south of the theater. Very good at repairing watches. I've been going to him for over 20 years. As a matter of fact, I remember when his kids were little kids and now they're all grown up out of college, have their own careers. He's a very, very nice person. And I bought a Continental watch, 17 jewels, anti-magnetic, Inca block. For you orologists, you'll know what that means. It had a damaged crystal, and the lume on the hands was pretty crappy. So he re-lumed the hands, cleaned the watch, put a new crystal in it. It's running great. Been almost 48 hours, hasn't lost or gained a minute. So I'm really happy with it. And then he did another vintage watch for me. I need to take some watches up there for batteries. Maybe tomorrow, I don't know. I don't know what's going on tomorrow. But how about that? For all you California people, I don't know where you're watching this, the rest of the world. We're going to have our first tropical storm in living memory. Maybe in the history of California. And they're on the news every day. Watch out, high winds. We could get 6 to 8 inches of rain over 2 days in a time of year when it's usually bone dry. We're going to get all this rain. They're worried about burn areas. So there's no burn areas that are recent near us. Well, there's a couple of small ones, but I mean big burn areas. I know up north there's some. My daughter has already had rain. But she lives in about 140 miles north of us. And then it's already raining out in where we camp out in the desert. It's a 100% chance of rain there today. Thunder and lightning, we're going to get that too. And high winds, supposedly. Now, is Bill holding his breath? No. Because all these weather people have cried wolf in the past, you know what I mean? And we haven't. I mean, we had pretty good rain last year. But not as, you know, okay, get ready, here comes a big one. Well, it rained, but it wasn't the big one, you know. But who knows? That is a good cigar. Like the old adage says, a woman is just a woman, but a good cigar is a smoke. And as the other old adage says, I would rather smoke here than hereafter. And one more shameless plug. I'm putting my 1952 Packard up for sale. If anybody's even remotely interested, you can see videos in the Ranwin Parked playlist. Shows a picture of the engine running. Contact me at radiumleague@gmail.com. All lowercase. Not that that matters. And, I know it's a shameless plug, you know, but I really need to get it out of here. But if you watched the previous video to this one, you'll know that. Anyway, enough about that. Any other news? Oh, and if you watched the previous video, you know my Gladiator's in the shop. Well, it's still in the shop. The parts were supposed to arrive today. Didn't happen. They might arrive tomorrow. If they don't, we're looking at things happening on Monday. So, and I'm supposed to go on a 600-mile round trip in a vehicle that I'm trusting the dealership to fix correctly. Not that they aren't. I'm not saying they can't do it. But I would like to drive it around a bit to make sure it's not going to, you know, Brody on me when I'm up by Bishop at 11,000 feet on this trail. But hey, anyhow, I guess that's about it. So once again, thanks for watching. Click like and subscribe. You'll see it up here somewhere. The thermometer says it's 80, but I don't think so. It's just way too mild for 80 degrees. But anyway, the bubble winked at me and said, "I'll miss you, brother, when you're dead." That was excellent. Well, folks, thanks for sticking with me. This will be a lot shorter than last week's. And until then, later, Mater.
Yes, look to Packard for the easiest handling car ever built. America's new choice in the fine car field.